Thank you for choosing St. Clair Health. I'm Dr. Andy Kaiser.
I'm Dr. Mohammed Salman. We are the cardiac surgeons here at St. Clair Health, and we'll manage your care during your time with us here.
We take great pride in the care you will receive as our patient. The following video will serve as a reference for your upcoming cardiac surgery.
Hi, my name is Dave Garber, and I'm a physician assistant in cardiac surgery and in the cardiothoracic intensive care unit, or the CTICU. The physician assistants and the nurse practitioners, along with Dr. Kaiser, Dr. Salman, as well as nurses, therapists, and other staff, provide a comprehensive team approach to your day-to-day care to enhance your recovery after surgery. Your surgery will take about 4 to 6 hours. You will be in the hospital about 5 to 7 days following your surgery before being discharged. On the day of your surgery, your family can visit you in your room in the CTICU from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. On a daily basis, the visiting hours are noon to 2 p.m. and 5 to 7 p.m.
Hello, my name is Kara Elder, and I'm a unit coordinator in the CTICU, where you will recover from your upcoming open heart surgery, where you will remain the entire time you're in the hospital. I will be discussing what to expect during your recovery period after open heart surgery. When you arrive to the CTICU from the operating room, you will have one-to-one nursing care for a minimum of 24 hours or longer if required. You will be sedated under general anesthesia with the breathing tube in place upon arrival to the nursing unit. There are many tubes and lines in place from surgery. Therefore, your hands will be restrained until you are able to follow directions from the nurse. As you begin to wake up from sedation, the ventilator or breathing tube will be weaned as long as your vital signs are stable and your lab work is within the appropriate limits as per our guidelines. You will be given medications to reverse the anesthesia. This will help you to wake up from the sedation with the breathing tube in place, which can be somewhat scary. Your nurse will guide you through the process of weaning off the ventilator. The most important thing for you to remember is listen to your nurse. While the breathing tube is in place, you will not be able to talk or swallow liquids. You will have several lines and tubes in place. We draw blood frequently, utilizing these lines that are in place. Every day as you recover, a line or tube will be removed. You will also have 4 chest tubes in place that will remain in for 2 to 3 days after surgery. These tubes drain excess fluid and blood from around the heart and lungs. As I stated, we check blood work frequently throughout your recovery. You may receive blood products as directed by the surgeon. Whether you're a diabetic or not, your blood sugar will increase due to the stress the surgery has on your body. You may be on a continuous insulin infusion or receive insulin before meals. We maintain a tight control on blood sugar so that your incisions heal properly. If you are not on insulin prior to surgery, you will not go home on insulin. We will manage your pain utilizing various IV and oral medications such as IV Tylenol and oral oxycodone. It is important for you to remember that this surgery is not pain-free. We will control your pain as best we can, but you also need to be awake and alert to get out of bed and ambulate. You will receive a red heart pillow that you will use to hold over your chest when you cough. This protects your sternum. Throughout your hospitalization, we will talk to you about protecting your chest, and you will be given specific instructions regarding sternal incision care and how to safely heal at home. There are expectations after heart surgery that include getting out of bed for every meal and walking a minimum of 3 times a day. The reasons for this include prevention of pneumonia, blood clots, and constipation. You will get out of bed for the first time around 6 a.m. the morning after your surgery. You will walk with a specific cardiac walker the first few days of your recovery. You will not walk alone during your stay. A staff member will be with you at all times. In addition, you will be instructed on the use of the incentive spirometer and flutter valve breathing exercises every 1 to 2 hours to help with lung expansion post-op. These exercises help to prevent pneumonia and help to get patients off oxygen. You will have a red fall bracelet placed on your wrist after surgery. Every patient that has received anesthesia and narcotics is considered a fall risk. In addition, you will have lines and tubes attached to you that are trip hazards. You will not be getting out of bed or ambulating alone. You will be on a fluid restriction during your hospital stay. Most open heart surgery patients gain an average of 10 pounds of fluid related to the surgery. Your hands and feet may be swollen for a few weeks. Most likely, you will receive a diuretic such as Lasix while you are in the hospital and upon discharge. This medication will help get rid of fluid retention related to surgery. Once the breathing tube is removed and your GI tract is starting to wake up, you will get ice chips and clear liquids. We will advance your diet as tolerated. It is common to not have a good appetite for a few days after surgery. You will be on a heart-healthy, low-sodium diet. It is very important to watch salt intake in order to avoid further fluid retention. A dietitian will meet you prior to discharge to discuss your dietary restrictions. You will receive this folder with information prior to your open heart surgery. In the folder, you will find this melon-colored paper titled Skin Preparation for Surgery. This paper gives a detailed description on how to use these two bottles of Betacept surgical scrub. This soap is used from your chin to your toes. You can use your normal shampoo and face soap. Use a clean washcloth and towel. Do not use any regular soap after your surgical baths. You will bathe with one entire bottle of soap the night before surgery and one entire bottle of soap before leaving home the morning of surgery. Please read the instructions prior to your first bath. As a review, the most important things to remember are: number one, listen to your nurse. Number two, you will experience pain, but we will try to minimize your pain as best we can. Number three, you will not get a lot of sleep, but we will get you back to bed for rest periods throughout the day. Number four, you will be expected out of bed for every meal. In addition, you will walk with the nurses in therapy a minimum of 3 times a day starting the day after surgery. And number five, you will be working on your breathing exercises every 1 to 2 hours while awake. Thank you for your time, and I look forward to taking care of you in the CTICU at St. Clair Health.
Hello, my name is Toni Heinen, and I am the manager of the CTICU. Thank you for taking the time to watch your pre-operative instructions. I look forward to taking care of you here at St. Clair Health.